So thank you so much for the introduction and give me an opportunity to give in the seminar. So today I will talk about my recent work on generalization of the Mukna-Nakajima rule for K-Schur function and K-Schur function. Okay. So first I will explain about the motivation of our research. So let f a variable x, your function, and we call this function is a symmetric function if it does not change when we apply any permutation sigma on variable x. And next lambda to be the gradient of a symmetric function in variable x with coefficient in z. So next lambda n to be the subset of lambda of all symmetric function of degree n. So we know that lambda n has a z basic. Given by the set of all the Schur function S lambda, where lambda is a partition of n. So for example, there are some fundamental symmetric polynomial in variable x1 to n. The first one is a elementary symmetric polynomial, and we denote it by ER. So that is the sum of all monomial xi1 to xir, so that the index i1 to ir are chosen from interval 1 to n, and they are strictly increased. And the second polynomial is complete homogeneous symmetric polynomial, and we denote it by SR, so again by the sum of all monomial xi1 to xir, such that the index i1 to ir are chosen from the interval 1 to n, and they are weakly increasing. And the next one is a power sum symmetric polynomial PR, so that even by the sum of all xi power r when xi run from x1 to xn. And the next one is a Schur function, so when we fix a partition lambda, when we can associate to it a Schur function S lambda, and even by the formula right here. So in the theory of symmetric function, we study some fundamental rule. So it gives us the branching rule when we take the multiplication of two symmetric functions. So more precisely, let lambda to be a partition of n, and r to be non-negative integer, not greater than n. The first rule is a Peake rule. So it tells us about the decomposition of elementary symmetric polynomial with Schur function into the sum of Schur function, and also the decomposition of homogeneous symmetric polynomial with Schur function into the sum of Schur function. And from Peake rule, we will know the Mukna-Nakajima rule. So namely, the Mukna-Nakajima rule give us the decomposition to the sum of Schur function of power sum symmetric polynomial with Schur function into the sum of Schur function. And the next one is the Little-Richardson rule. So when you take the product of two Schur function S lambda and S mu, and you decompose them to the sum of Schur function S nu, so it we call the decomposition here is a Little-Richardson rule. Now I will explain about the connection of the theory of symmetric function to other domain. So the first connection to representation theory. So namely, when we study the representation theory of GLN, next V lambda to be irreducible module associated to lambda, and V mu also irreducible module associated to mu. We want to compute the branching rule when of the tensor product of V lambda with V mu. So to do this, we associate the character of V lambda with the Schur function S lambda, and the character of V mu with Schur function S mu. And from the Little-Richardson rule of S lambda and S mu, we will know the decomposition of V lambda tensor V mu to the sum of venu. So the coefficient say lambda mu nu here is exactly the little word Richard coefficient appearing in the breaching rule for S lambda and S mu. And we also can compute the character table of Sn by using the Mukna-Hanakayama rule. So similarly, in the cohomology theory, we study the cohomology ring of a Grassmannian, and we know that in this case, the cohomology ring of Grassmannian had a basic, the basic parameters by partition, and the basics of the cohomology ring of Grassmannian, we call this one is Schwarz class, and Adilos here by sigma lambda. So a central problem in the cohomology ring theory of Grassmannian is to try to compute the product of two Schwarz class. So to compute S lambda times S mu, we associate S lambda to a symmetric function S lambda. And we associate sigma lambda, sigma mu to a symmetric function S mu. So the branching rule for S lambda times S mu give us the branching rule of sigma lambda times sigma mu. And there are application of the cohomology theory into the counting problem in algebraic geometry. So namely, we consider four line, four general line in projective space of dimension 3. So I denote here by L1, L2, and L3 and L4. And the question is, how many lines meet the line 1, L1 to L4? And to answer this question, we transform the question into the question in cohomology theory of Grassmannian. So in this case, we consider Grassmannian of subspace of dimension 2 in C4. And in this case, the cohomology ring of Grassmann G24 has a basics sigma lambda, where lambda is a partition inside a box of psi 2,2. So to come to answer the coupling problem in algebraic geometry, we then need to compute the product sigma one box four times. And from the theory of the symmetric function, we know that sigma one box four times equal 2 times of sigma of partition 2,2 here. And the coefficient appearing in the decomposition of sigma one box four times here is exactly the counting number we need to know in the algebraic geometry. Now similarly, we try to transform the cohomology theory to quantum K theory. And it can be done by replacing cohomology by quantum K cohomology or quantum K homology or K cohomology or K homology, and we plot the Grassmannian alpha Grassmannian by another geometry optics. And what we are doing here, so we try to find the Mukna-Hanakayama rule in quantum K theory, but in the symmetric function version. So let me explain about this precisely. So we consider the alpha Grassmannian, and we know that the homology ring of a Grassmannian had a Z basic parameters by partition lambda with lambda one in not greater than k. And in this case, we denote the Schwarz class associated to lambda by sigma lambda k. And to compute the product of two Schwarz class, sigma lambda k and sigma mu k, we associate sigma lambda k to k Schwarz function. And I denote the k Schwarz function is k by S lambda k. And so you see the product of two Schwarz class on the right hand side can be computed through the product of two Schwarz k Schwarz function, S lambda k and S mu k. When we try to decompose them into the sum of other k Schwarz function, S mu k, we will know the decomposition in the homology ring of alpha Grassmannian. Now similarly, when we replace homology ring by K homology, we also have a similar story. So the K homology of alpha Grassmannian also had a Z basic parameters by partition lambda, such that lambda 1 is not greater than K. And in this case, we denote the Schubert class, K Schubert class associated to lambda by theta lambda K. And what we want to know is the product of two Schubert class in K homology of alpha Grassmannian. So to do this, we associate theta lambda K to KK Schur function, and we denote here by G lambda K. And we also have a similar story. So the product of two KK Schur function G lambda K with G mi K. And when we decompose this product into the sum of G mi K, G nu K, we will know the decomposition of the product of two Schubert class theta lambda K and theta mu K into the sum of theta nu K. So before going to the main result, I need to talk about some basic definition. So let lambda to be a partition. So that is a set of, that is a sequence of non-negative integer lambda 1, lambda 2, and so on. And the entry here are quickly decreasing. For a partition, we can associate to it a Young diagram. So namely, that is a set of box in the plane, such that there are one lambda 1 box in the first row, and there are lambda 2 box in the second row, and so on. And all box in the all first box in each row are in the same column. For example, when you take lambda equal 2, 4, 1, 1, so we can associate to this partition a Young diagram. You see here. So in the first row, I put 4 box because lambda 1 equal 4. In the second row, I put 2 box because lambda 2 equal 2, and so on. In the third and the ninth row, I put 1 box. Now, from a partition, we can define a conjugate partition. So namely, we read the Young diagram associated to partition lambda by column. So when you read the first column of lambda, you get a lambda t1. And when you read the second column of lambda, you get lambda t2, and so on. And we denote the partition by collecting lambda t1, lambda t2, and so on by lambda t. So for example, here, when lambda equals 4, 2, 1, 1, we have the conjugate partition of lambda equals 4, 2, 1, 1. So in this case, it is the same like lambda, but the way we read the Young diagram is different. So you read the column, the first column of lambda, so you get 4 box, and you read the second column of lambda, you get 2 box, and so on. You get the third and the last column of lambda, you get 1 box. And then I have lambda t equal 4 to 1, 1. Now I suppose that another partition and it contains lambda. Then I can define the skew shape mu over lambda by removing all box in the Young diagram of lambda from the Young diagram of mu. And we call the skew shape a ribbon if it does not contain any square of psi 2 2. So for example, when you take mu equal 4, 2, 2, 1, 1, 1, then you can associate mu to a Young diagram here. And from the Young diagram, you can see that mu contains lambda. And then in this case, we can define the skew shape mu over lambda by removing all box from the Young diagram of lambda. And you can check that This could shape your ribbon because there are no box upside to no square upside to 2. Now, when a skew shape your ribbon, we can define the height of a ribbon by counting the number of vertical domino inside the skew shape. So in this case, in this example, you see there are only one domino, vertical domino inside the skew shape. There are two box in the bottom of the skew shape, and then the height of the skew shape in this case equal 1. Now I will explain some partition between a partition lambda with lambda 1 not greater than k with other object called element in a symmetrical roof and allow the partition kappa lambda. So first, next sk plus 1 delta be the affine symmetrical roof. So that is a group with generator S0 to Sk, and it satisfies the Renison S Renison here. So Si square is the identity. And the breadth Renison, I denote by A and B. So we remark that the index of the generator here are taken from Z over K plus 1 Z. Now the symmetric group is a subgroup of alpha symmetric group with generator S1 to Sk, and I denote the symmetric group by Sk plus 1. So to be simple, I denote the element Si1 to Sik by Si1 to Ik. Now for a given partition lambda, such that lambda 1 not greater than k, where the partition between lambda and element in the affine symmetric group and allow the partition kappa lambda. So I do not give a general definition of the partition here. So you can find in my paper. But I can visualize how we define the partition, three partition, P, S, and P through example. So let's take k equal 4 and choose lambda equal 4 to 1 1. So to construct a partition between lambda and allow the element in the affine symmetric group, I denote here by W lambda. So we first draw a table. So in the first row, you write 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and you repeat 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Well, for the second row, you shift the first row to the right one step. And for the third row, you shift the second row to the right one step, and so on. And now you try to fill the table. You have a quiz by the shape lambda. So you see in the picture, in the first row, I put four red circle, start from 0, and from the cell, and in the second row, I put two box because there are two. Because lambda one equal lambda two equal 2, and so on. For the third and the last rows, I put one circle because lambda 3 and lambda 4 equal 1. Now you can read the table by the direction from top to bottom and in each rows, you read from right to left. So you see, you read the table of red circle from the top and from the bottom, you get number 2, and then 3, and then 0 and 4, and you go to the next, I go to the fourth row, that is 3, 2, 1, 0, and now you get the index of the element W lambda. And now To construct a larger partition kappa lambda from W lambda, we also create a table like before. So you write 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and repeat, and then you shift the first row to get second row, and you shift the second row to the right one step to get the third row, and so on. And now you read the index from W lambda from right to left. So you start from the index 0. So for 0, you find all entry in the table, such that it forms a partition. So you see there are only one choice, that is 0 in the first row. So you put one circle. Yeah. Next, you read the entry 1, and you see there is only one choice, that is 1 in the first row after 0. Such that when we make a circle here, we get a partition. So that is 2. And next 3, like you read the index 2, you see there are only one choice in the first rows, such that we have a partition. So we put one circle for 2 in the first row, and next for 3, we also have only one choice. But now when we read the index 4, you see there are two choice, 4 in the first row and 4 in the second row. It make a partition. So that's why before you put two circle. Well, the first one is in the first row and the first one is 4 in the second row. And you read to 0 and it is similar. So when you read 0, there are also two choice, 0 in the first row and 0 in the second row. It make a partition. So we put two circle for 0. And next for 3 and 2, you have only one choice. So there are 3 in the third row and 2 in the fourth row. And now you just record the shape of the table you have created here. So in the first row you have a thick circle. So that's why I put kappa lambda, the first component of kappa lambda, to be thick. And in the second row, you have a two circle. So that's why I put the second component to be of kappa lambda to be 2. And so on, in the third and the last row, you have a one circle. So I put the last two index by 1, 1. Now net AK to be an associative algebra over Z with a generator A0 to AK, and it satisfies the relation defined the alpha symmetric group A and B. So here. And to be simple, I also denote the element A I1 to AIR by A I1 to IR. Now, when we for any non-negative integer R net not equal K, and a proper subset A of Z over K plus 1 Z, such that the cardinality of A equal R, I can define the two elements dA and IA. So D here mean decrease, and I here mean increase. So it's given by A of index I1 to IR, where I1 to IR is a rearrangement of A, such that if index I and I plus 1 appear in A, then I plus 1 occur before I. And to obtain the element IA, we then need to reorder the index of dA from right to left. So for example, when I take k equal 4 and a equals 0 to 4, so that is a proper subset of z modulo phi z. And in this case, you can compute dA and IA. So dA can be written as a 0 for 2 and a 0 to 4. And now when you read the index of DA from right to left, you can get the expression of IA. Now from DA and IA, we can construct some elementary non-commutative symmetric function. So the first one, as R is a non-commutative homogeneous symmetric function. So it's given by the sum of all DA, where A taken from the subset of all the set of all subset of the interval 0 to k with cardinality equal R. And now for ER, so that is a non-commutative elementary symmetric function. It given by the similar formula for homogeneous symmetric function, but we replace DA by IA. And from homogeneous and elementary symmetric function, we can define the Hochschild function by this formula, by the third formula. And the power sum symmetric function, it defined through the Hochschild function. Now I suppose that the algebra IK acts on the group ring of half-phi symmetric group through phi. So the action of element alpha on W given by this notation. So alpha star phi and W. And I suppose that per C, your function from AK time alpha symmetric group to R. And we say that per C is phi compatible if it satisfies this relation. And now when we fix phi and per C, we can define a family of symmetric function here denoted by FWK. With the index W here belongs to the set of own minimum Lyapunov set representative of affine symmetric group, and it satisfies three relations. So the first one is a function associated to the identity element, and the next two condition here is a formal PK rule. So it tells us the decomposition when you take product of FWK with homogeneous symmetric function, and the product of FWK with elementary symmetric function. And you know that so for each element W in the set of mean and cosine representative of alpha symmetric group, we can associate to it a partition lambda such that lambda 1 not greater than k through this bisection. Yeah. So from this bisection, we can define here the symmetric function f lambda k by f w lambda k. So there are some example of F that satisfy this condition. So the first one, when we consider action of AK on group ring of alpha symmetric group, defined by this formula. So when you take AI acts on W, it gives you SIW if the length of SIW greater than the length of W. And it give you W if the length of SIW less than the length of W. And in this case, we choose a function per C even by the formula. So you can easily you can check that this function satisfy the reason of phi comparable. And in this case, the function f, fwk, coincide with the kk sure function jwk. And in the second example, so if you define the action of ak on group ring of alpha symmetric group by this formula, so it similar like the first example, but when the length si w less than the length of w, you set the image of ai on w by zero. And in this case, if you choose per c by one, then it automatically satisfies the condition phi comparable. And in this case, the symmetric function fwk coincides with the k-sure function swk. Now for a word inside AK, let's add to be the support of the word. So for example, when I take k equal 4, and I choose a word u equal 0, 4, 2, 4 inside a 4, then I can compute the support of u. So that is a set of all index appearing in u. So this, you see that in this case, the support of u equal 0 to 4. And from the support of u, we can define the canonical cyclic interval of s. So namely, for the first step, you choose a minimum element in this interval 0k, such that it does not belong to s. And the next step, you can define the cyclic interval is by a plus 1 less than a plus 2 and so on, and go back to a minus 1. So for example, you see in the example, you have the support of u equals 0 to 4, and in the intervals from 0 to 4, there are two index that do not belong to 0 to 4. So that is the first one, that does not belong to s. So the first one is 1, and the second one is 3. But you see, 1 is the minimum element that does not belong to s. So I fix a equal 1. And now you read from 2 to the right and go back to 0. So you get the cyclic interval is. So that equal 2, less than 3, less than 4, and less than 0. So we call u k connected if the support here an interval of is, and we call this one here weak word if have a reduced word of form decrease and increase, and we say the hook tie is v. The reason we say the hook tie is v because the shape of v, even so like decrease and increase. Or it have form decrease and ui equal ui plus 1 for some I and then increase. And in this case, we say that the hook tie of the word is u. The reason we choose u because the shape of u is also decrease and equal and increase. And we denote the number of outside of hook form with respect to the order is by ascu. So for example, when we take s equals 0, 4, 2, we look at on the interval is, we see that there are 1 and 3, 3 does not belong to S, and it divides the interval IS to disjoint interval 2 and 4, 0. So you can conclude that U is not for connectors. And now when you see the behavior of the index in U, you see that decrease from 0 to 2 and then increase from 2 to 4. So you see that the hook type of the word U in this case is V. And the number of ascent of U is 1 because we only have one ascent from 2 to 4. Now, if we denote the say U to be the set of non-consecutive pair A less than C such that A is different from C minus 1, and there are no entry B between A and C in the hook form of U. If we take the minimum index C among the pair A and C in the CU, we can get an index C mean. And there are a fact that the number of C mean will belong to 0, 1, or 2. So, for example, in this case, you see there are two pairs, A less than C, in the hook form. So that is 4 greater than 2 and 2, and so that is the first pair, and the next is 2 less than 4. And from this, you can see that the semin, the index semin is 4. And the index semin appear in the left and the right side of the hook form V. So in general, when we pick up a word in AK, we can classify it into three types. So U can be connected or disconnected. And in the case U disconnected, we count the number of same means. So if it equal 2, then we combine it with the condition connected to make a new class. So we call this one here. We connectors word, and when the number of semin equal 1, we consider the size of semin on the hook form. So if semin on the left side of the hook form, we say that the word is not weak connected, and we put nef mean the size of semin. And when semin on the right, then we say that the word is not weak connected, and we put right mean semin on the right of the hook form. So to record the information of word U, we use the notation here. So for example, when I put U belong to big V and I, W, C, and R, mean the number of letter of U equal R. So the index R above V, big V means the number of letter. And V, big V means the hook type of U. And I, the index I in the below V means the number of ascent of U. And WC here means weak connectors. And similarly, we use another notation with U. Another index. So for example, we already know that the word 0424 here a word in of type V, one quick connected, and it has 4 letters. Now I start to state the main result. So first, to simplify the notation, I use F equal and I put dot above, mean F is the sum of all element U, which U belong to S. So the first lemma will give you the cancellation free formula for power sum symmetric polynomial. So you can see is given by the sum of all element of all good with coefficient minus 1 power I, and the word are chosen from the set VI WCR, and there are some words taken from the set U of type U, UI minus 1 with connected and the number of letter ER, and here the hook tie EU and the number of ascending I minus 1 and it not with connected and same on the left and the number of letter ER also. So from this lemma, we can obtain the Mona Nakayama rule for AK. So it says that it requires a condition that if the function C UV only depend on the wavelength of the word and the image of U acts on W and W itself, then we can rewrite it as a function for C theta in three variables R, W prime, and W. Then the Mona Nakayama rule for FWK given by this formula. So we see to compute the coefficient of inside the coefficient of the decomposition, we need to know the set of words of hook words of type V U here. And in the notation, I put W prime above the hook tie, mean that is a set of subset of own word U such that U acts on W equal W prime. So the first application of the Mona Nakayama rule, the general Mona Nakayama rule, is the Mona Nakayama rule for KK Schur function. So it can obtain when we consider the action of AK on group ring of alpha symmetric group given by this formula. So you already checked before. Now you get the first corollary. So the first formula exactly is the formula for the general case, but we just replace FWK by GWK. And you know that's the eight element W in the set of minimum Nyquist set representative of alpha symmetric group can be associated to a partition lambda so that lambda 1 not greater than k. So we can translate the first formula to a new formula through and with the function g w k replaced by g lambda k. And with the new formula, we put more condition on the partition mu appear in the decomposition such that we make sure that with mu satisfy phi condition here, the coefficient should be zero, should be non-zero. And the next example is the Mugnan Kanak, and the next coronary is a Mugnan Nakayama rule for K Schur function. So we consider the action of AI of the unzero AK on alpha symmetric on the grouping of alpha symmetric group through this action, this formula. And you know that by this by the definition of the action here, you can check that AI square acts on W equals zero. Because so first you suppose that AI acts on W in non-zero, it means the length of SI W greater than the length of W. And now when you apply one more time AI on AI W, you see that the length of of SIW decrease 1, and it belongs to the second condition, the second case. So it gives you 0. So from this property, you can see that the Mugnan Nakajima rule for K-Schur function is a degeneration of the Mugnan Nakajima rule for K-Schur function. So more precisely, you look at the formula here. Is it a simplification of the formula here for K-Schur function? So we remove the set of the set of own word of Huktai U because of the condition AI square acts on W equals 0. You see that when you take any word of size U, then it have from a decrease and UI equal UI plus 1 and then increase. And you see that at the place UI equal UI plus 1, if you apply this this pair on W, you get 0. So that's why you have to remove on who word of type U. So furthermore, you can see the set of type V appearing in the rule for K-Schur function also simpler than the set of type V for K-Schur function. You see the condition that we connected is replaced by the condition connectors. The reason is that when you pick any word in the set V here, but it is weak connected but not connected, then by definition you know that here, so it belongs to the second case. So U should be deconnected and the number of semi-nodes equal 2. And by this condition, you can apply certain move on the word on the letter of U to transform it to the form like decrease or decrease and UI equal UI plus 1 and decrease and increase, or decrease and increase and UI equal UI plus 1 and increase, something like this. So you one way can put two letter, the same letter together, and now you apply the property that AI squared acts on W equals 0. You can remove own word it is weak connected but not connected from the set of type V here, and that's why you only guess the word of type V, and it is connected, not I mean it's stronger than weak connected. Now similarly to the K-Schur function, you can translate the result to the formula in terms of partition me. And I also put five condition here to make sure that when you choose me satisfy the condition, then the coefficient should be non-zero. And another new result is that in each case for K-Schur function and K-Schur function, we also give an effective algorithm to find the set which contribute to the decomposition. And then we can compute the coefficient easily by hand. So for example, we study the rule for K-Schur function. And in this case, I suppose K equal 4 and R equal 4, and I choose lambda be 4211 and mu equal 4221. And from the position I already explained before, you can compute the partition kappa lambda and kappa mu. So it's given by 6211 and 73221. And now from the partition kappa lambda and kappa mu, we create a table a table like this. So we also write 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and repeat, and then you shift the first row to the second row one step, and from second row to third row one step, and so on. And now we try to make a shape kappa lambda and kappa to the table. You have a crease here, so you remove the table of shape kappa lambda, but you keep the table of shape kappa mi. Then you get a skew tableau of shape kappa mi over kappa lambda. And our algorithm on this skew tableau give us the set of own homework we need to find to know to compute the coefficient in the Mona-Nakayama rule. So you can find the description in the paper. But here I just write directly the result. So the algorithm give us 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 words. And when you try to look at the data, the statistic of the word, you can see the first one, 1, 0, 3, 4, belong to the set of word of type V and with one accent, and it is weak connected, and similar for the second one, that is V2 weak connected, and so on. But you see in this case, the fifth word is 1, 1, 3, 4. It is a hook word of type U with two accent, and it is not weak connected. And in this case, the indexing mean is on the right of the hook type U. So we have to remove this, because you see in the formula of Kekeshwar function, you see, we have some word of type U. And when the word is not weak connected, we require the condition that the indexing mean should be on the left of the hook type U. So there are no word of type U, not weak connected, and semin on the right. So that's why you have to remove the fifth word here. And now you apply the formula for Kekeshwar function. You can compute explicitly the coefficient of J mu 4 in P 4 times J lambda 4. So that equals minus 3. And now I will talk a bit about the future direction of research. So the Mona-Nakayama rule for FWK is not only cover the rule for Kekeshwar function J lambda K and Kekeshwar function L lambda K, but also it also cover several class, other symmetric function. So you can see in my paper, there are some symmetric function here that they are dual Kekeshwar function and are phi stable one-lick polynomial or closed Kekeshwar function or closed Kekeshwar function and so on. So the first direction is try to describe in detail the Mona-Nakayama rule for own function here. And the second direction is translate the Mona-Nakayama rule here to the Mona-Nakayama rule in quantum K theory or quantum cohomology of flag variety through Peterson isomorphism or K Peterson isomorphism. So the Peterson isomorphism give you the bisection between the homology of alpha Grassmannian and quantum cohomology of flag variety. And the K-Peterson isomorphism give you the bisection between K homology of alpha Grassmannian and quantum K cohomology of flag variety. And from this, you can associate each symmetric function, say, F G lambda K And S lambda k here to spec class. And then you can transform the formula, I mean the Mook Nakayama rule above to the Mook Nakayama rule for spec class. So that is the second direction. So thank you so much for your attention.